You know what is crazy frustrating? I'll show you.
This window unit is supposed to be cooling all of this equipment, but I come in here and it's not blowing anything. Why? Because for the third time this week, it's done this. Solid ice. No movement, no cooling action, just a chunk of ice, and I'm done.
So instead of cooling down this room, all it's doing is using more energy, which creates more heat. Let's change this.
All right, so this guy is coming out of the wall. We're gonna go ahead and replace it now.
So what we need to do is jump in the truck and drive up to Sulphur Springs, Texas, and go down to Signature Solar. I'm gonna pick up a 9,000 BTU unit mini split from EG4. These things are incredible. I've got the 24,000 BTU unit in my living room. You can check out those videos that I posted last year. That thing is a rock star. It's been keeping us nice and cool. Signature Solar has a great storefront. You can get anything that you need for your solar projects. And you know, most of the stuff you can't find at Lowe's or Home Depot or anywhere local. So it's awesome. It's kind of like being a kid in a candy store for solar enthusiasts. And of course, these guys are real professional. They loaded up my truck without any issues. And while we're flying around Signature Solar, this is a good time to mention, if you want to buy anything from them and you want a $50 discount, go ahead and start first at shopeth.link. That's shopeth.link. And there you will find the most up-to-date discount code. While in the parking lot, I couldn't help but notice the Chico carports. These things are super cool. Man, I want to get a few of these things to make a massive back porch on the back of my house. That would be awesome. So let me know if you want to see that series, because I would really like to make that happen. But enough dreaming. Let's get back to the house and unbox this thing.
So I've already cut it open, so you don't have to watch me do that. And we're going to go ahead and look and see what's inside the box. You got a manual. Now, I always recommend that you check online to make sure you have the most up-to-date information, because as time goes by, they definitely go through and update the manuals. I'm not sure how much that pertains to the EG4 mini splits, but definitely with the inverters as they add features. So check that out for sure. And you can find that, of course, at eg4electronics.com. So we're going to set this aside for a minute. One thing I always love is that they have these templates. And that makes it really handy to go over here and say, you know, this is where I want this to hang on the wall, and then allows you to hang your bracket and figure out exactly where you want things. So that's pretty cool. Let's set this aside for a moment. And sorry about the audio. My mic is busted at the moment. So then we've got our packet with some barcodes, which I never really know what those are for. I think they're going to be for just your serial number for warranty claims. Then you've got the little guy here that's going to go through the wall. That's going to clean things up a bit. Got some putty. That always helps you clean, make sure that you don't have bugs and stuff coming in. And then, of course, some anchors, sheetrock anchors, more sheetrock anchors. Then we've got the Allen wrench, and of course, and then some batteries. Why do we need batteries? Well, that's for the remote, which is going to be stuffed over here. And the remote may or may not get used by you. I go back and forth on using the remote on my 24,000 BTU unit inside the house. It can get a little tricky. The funny thing is, if you make a change on the remote and then you go and you make a change on the app, the remote stays showing what your last change was. And so, at least for larger units. And so then if you bump the temp up or something, you can bump it up from where it is currently. It's actually changing it based on what the remote says. So the remote's not receiving information about what the current setting is. It simply has what the remote's last program to do. So if you say, bump the temperature up 1 degree, it's bumping it up and writing whatever it is. This is not making any sense. I'll try to clear it up a little bit later. It can be finicky. I end up using the app for almost every setting. So, but you still want to have a remote. We've got our hose. This is for the condensation drip. It's going to go out the back. Of course, you've got to hook this into the head unit and then go through the wall with it. We'll cover all that in the next video. How do I want to get this guy out of here? Oh, these come out. That's cool. And I kind of want to just tip this upside down. Okay. I don't think there's any risk in it going upside down. but it's probably not recommended. Okay, while it's upside down, we can notice we've got some more of the tape. We're gonna have some of this in the outside unit box, and that's to just tape up your line set, make sure everything looks good. While we're here, we've got this bracket. We're gonna need to take this one screw out. I'm gonna find a screwdriver.
What am I doing? I'm gonna start going through and installing this thing. It's not time to install it. That's in the next video. Word of advice, before you get it where it's going to go, don't pop the bands, because then you have to put a strap on it or something, because well, that's what keeps the top from coming off. So let's go ahead and look inside, see what we've got. I opened it up because I was looking for the manual. It was in the other box. All right, so there's the unit. And by the way, hey there, this is Eric from the future again. I got confused. I didn't know where I was at in the filming of these 3-4 parts. So I got it all mixed up. I'm sorry. That's the pad. I did a bad job with it. But hey, you know what? We'll come back to that in a future video. And let's get back to what's in the box. See, what else do we have in here? We've got basically the line set, which we'll just set here for a second. Look under here, make sure everything looks good. And I guess that's pretty much the only thing in this box. Oh, hey, me again. I guess I'm blind. So clearly right here, we've got more tape for the line set, and then it's kind of hard to see, but it was also very easy for me to see. At that point, we've got the drain for the bottom of the unit. Here we can see the energy efficiency. This thing is actually really great. It's a SEER 229, which is kind of nuts. Super high efficiency.